Good morning. Here is today's word of blessings for you. 1 Thessalonians 3:6-10. But Timothy has just now come to us from you and has brought good news about your faith and love. He has told us that you always have pleasant memories of us and that you long to see us, just as we also long to see you. Therefore, brothers and sisters, in all our distress and persecution we were encouraged about you because of your faith. For now we really live, since you are standing firm in the Lord. How can we thank God enough for you in return for all the joy we have in the presence of our God because of you? Night and day we pray most earnestly that we may see you again and supply what is lacking in your faith. Today's title is Now We Live, Since You Are Standing Firm. I once heard a man jokingly say that he doesn't want to go to heaven because heaven seems to be a place so calm and peaceful, even to the point of boring, without any excitement. What do you think? I don't think that any real Christian would agree with what he said. But I think I understand why he said so. People often associate heaven with deep religiosity which lacks vitality. There are some popular misconceptions about heaven among non-believers or weak believers. They stress the peace of heaven so much so that the joy and happiness of heaven are often overlooked. I believe that's not true at all. The Bible clearly shows that heaven is the most joyous place with great happiness and excitement. Jesus said, "Truly I tell you, unless you change and become like little children, you will never enter the kingdom of heaven," Matthew 18:3. Of course, Jesus was primarily pointing to the humility of the little children. At the same time, joy and happiness which are the mark of healthy children seem to be implied to me. The Bible also says all the days of the oppressed are wretched, but the cheerful heart has a continual feast. Proverbs 15:15. I believe this is the typical mindset of the heavenly residents. That was probably why the Bible says rejoice always, pray continually, give thanks in all circumstances, for this is God's will for you in Christ Jesus. 1 Thessalonians 5:16-18. So what gives us such joy and happiness while we are still on earth? We see a good example of Christians' true joy and happiness in today's passage. Paul, who was under persecution, expresses great joy and happiness in this passage. How can we thank God enough for you in return for all the joy we have in the presence of our God because of you? What made him so full of joy? It was the news that the Thessalonians were standing firm in faith and love despite the trials and temptation. He even says, "For now we really live, since you are standing firm in the Lord." I believe this indeed shows the heart of the Lord. He rejoices with all the believers when a sinner repents and returns. I tell you that in the same way, there will be more rejoicing in heaven over one sinner who repents than over 99 righteous persons who do not need to repent. Luke 15:7. He is filled with joy when a believer stands firm even in persecution. Do you share the joy of the Good Shepherd? Then you must be destined to heaven.